Back-to-back C's. Assistant professor of history, Sarah Elizabeth Lewis writes, quote, Martin Luther King Jr. did well in school, but his worst grades were in public speaking. Yes, two C's in back-to-back terms, unquote. If you know anything about history, you know that Martin Luther King Jr. perfected the art of public speaking. There is something to be said about people who look back at their mediocre results and use them as a stepping stone instead of an excuse or a roadblock to future success. Let me share that again. There is something to be said about people who look back at their mediocre results and use them as a stepping stone instead of an excuse or a roadblock to future success. These people leverage their struggles and lack of results to push them forward instead of holding them back. I think of Albert Einstein, who was told when he was young that he, quote, wouldn't amount to anything, unquote. Aren't you glad that Mr. Einstein didn't allow the opinion of that individual to discourage him? There are dozens of famous people who were told they weren't good enough and went on to be successful. Here's where it can get a little tricky for some people. There are some folks who take the negative opinions of some people as and view them as fact. One person's negative opinion of you does not have to become your destiny. Once again, one person's negative opinion of you does not have to become your destiny. The great basketball player Michael Jordan once said, quote, I've missed over 9,000 shots in my career. I've lost almost 300 games. On 26 occasions, I have been entrusted to take the game-winning shot, and I've missed. I have failed over and over and over again in my life, and that is why I succeed, unquote. There's a common thread throughout the lives of so many people who became successful. They didn't allow the negative opinions of other people to distract them from their passion in life. This is where you must take control. If you have people in your life who are planting negative seeds in your mind, you must get away from those people. Let me share it once more. If you have people in your life who are planting negative seeds in your mind, you must get away from those people. These people could include family members and close friends. It's like walking through poison ivy and thinking that you won't break out in a rash. You see, the negative words that you allow to enter your ears will stop you in your tracks. There are several habits that the really successful people do to push them to the top. Let me just share a few of them. Number one, they read a lot. They know that they don't have to have all the answers and read a lot of books to help them in their journey to the top. Number two, they work out because they understand that a strong body is the first step in having a strong mind. They work out consistently. Number three, they understand that failing is not the same as being a failure. Number four, they realize that if they allow their ego to rule, they will never be successful. Number five, they surround themselves with positive people. Number six, they have mastered the ability to say no to opportunities and conversations that take them off track. And number seven, they write down their goals every single day. So if you're serious about reaching a high level of success, you have to develop the constant and never-ending improvement system, C-A-N-I, constant and never-ending improvement. This is the key to the best of the best, being the best of the best. They purposely push themselves to master their craft while understanding that they will fail many times on their way to the top. So it doesn't matter if you got back-to-back C's, but what matters is what you do after you get those average grades. Do you accept the average grades as a metaphor for your future, or are you going to push yourself until you become excellent? You only have one life. Tony Robbins once said, we only learn our limits by going beyond them. Again, we only learn our limits by going beyond them. So if you look back in your life and see the evidence of being average and ordinary, it does mean that you could remain that way for your life, but you don't have to be. So choose to become the best of the best. My name is John Carver. I do believe in you. Thanks for listening.